Welcome back to Team G503. We're doing the fuel strainer or fuel filter. In the last video, we put the cap there and we installed it onto the firewall. Now we're going to be challenged with the task of getting the fuel lines from the passenger side of the vehicle over to the driver's side. And you see here we've got our starter and our generator all installed in our brackets and our oil filter, so it's going to make it a little difficult to get that line through there and over here to the driver's side of the Jeep, where it's going to inevitably come over the timing cover there, and then it's going to connect with our fuel pump here that's on the lower part of the driver's side of the engine. As you see, I've got a little cloth there plugged up on the fitting to protect that, and I'll show you exactly what the line is I'm talking about. Now, this is the line that comes pre-bent in the Ron Fitzpatrick parts kit. It's a fuel line kit, and you see we've got our cotton loom on there, and you see how this is all kind of, it's got a funny little bend to it. It's a little difficult to get in there, but I'm going to show you a trick that's going to make it easy. Okay, I've changed camera angles here. I've got a little light down there shining on the camshaft cover. And what we're going to do is I'm going to show you the top of this, the fitting that goes to the side. It looks like a little angle like that with a fitting on it. That's the one that goes to the fuel pump. This opposite side here kind of rolls around the engine underneath the generator and on top of the splash shield. We're going to route this line right through here on top of the timing cover where this oil line meets the timing cover. And this is where it gets a little tricky. I'm going to come in at a little angle with that fitting, the 45 there, at an angle upwards. We're going to push it past the timing cover, and here's where it gets a little tight, and you've kind of got to manipulate this up and down. Do not force it, and do not catch it on anything and get a bend in it, otherwise you're going to be upset and have to replace the line. Once you get that past, and you feel it underneath the oil filter there, you simply roll it around the backside here like I'm showing you, the generator, and then that will lay right down onto your splash shield. I'll show you from a different angle. We're looking down here in the middle of the generator and the block, engine block, and you see there how I've got that resting down there on the generator. It just touches, and how it goes back over the top and behind the bracket that holds the generator to the block. I'll zing over here to the driver's side, and we'll take a look here how it comes over the top of the timing cover if I can get the camera down here for you to see it. And then we can look there how that 90-degree bend meets up almost exactly with that fitting that's on that fuel pump. Our next move is going to be attach that fitting to the fuel pump, so we'll go ahead there and remove that little cloth plug I've got to keep the dust out. The first thing you want to do is you want to make sure that this is straight up and down and everything lines up exactly so the fitting goes in perfectly and the flare fits inside the fitting perfectly. If you need to make any adjustments here, go ahead and do it now, but make sure that that's lined up so you can get the threads in easily. Before I install the fitting here, I'm going to use a little high temp gas sealant to seal the line. A lot of people like to use a sealant and some don't. I've used the sealant for years on many applications with the Jeeps and other automobile applications, and I've never had an issue with the sealant. The biggest thing you want to do is when you put this sealant on, you want to make it sure it's a thin coat that just covers the thread. I think the problem a lot of folks get into is they feel like they need to use a lot of sealant and then they force it inside the threads when they put it the fitting on where it goes onto the other fitting, and then they actually cause themselves problems by having some of that sealant gob into the fuel line, causing issues with the fuel filter or fuel pump later. So you just need enough to cover the threads, and then we'll go ahead in here and get this started by hand. Again, you want to be able to just line this straight up and down without any trouble, and those threads should screw into each other with no issues. Don't make the mistake of trying to use a wrench and try to force the fitting on there in order to get the line to go where it's at. We're just going to take a flare nut wrench here now, and I'm not going to tighten these all the way up because I may need to make adjustments on the other side, so I'm just going to get them snugged up for the time being. And that'll leave me a little leeway or slack for when I install the clip on the opposite side of the engine block. I will run this down so it's tight, just so I will still be able to move it just a little bit. I'm just not going to do the final snug on the fuel pump just yet. Okay, here's the clip that we need to install. This comes with the Ron Fitzpatrick fuel line kit. You can also buy one for the electrical. These clips are certain sizes and need to be in certain locations on the Jeep. And you look down inside there and you're going to see where that bracket comes through, the engine mounting plate there, where that bracket for our generator comes. That's the bolt that we're going to attach this clip to. You see the wire loom is kind of halfway on and halfway off that radius, and we're going to line that up just above that bolt, and that's where we're going to install our clip. Before I loosen the nut and remove the star washer, I am releasing the pressure off of that bracket from the generator, just in case. I don't want any pressure on that when I take that nut and that washer off. Okay, here you can see how it's mounted. The actual roll towards the clip is towards you, and the flat side's towards that engine bracket. And just put the lock washer back on and the nut, and then you can tighten that back down, and then you'll have to reinstall the spring-loaded arm that holds the generator. And that's not difficult to do. We've got a video here somewhere in the series about that. All right, back to the passenger side here where we've got that splash guard, and we've got this flexible line that we're going to have to install with two female fittings on each side of the end. Those are flare nut fittings, and that'll give you a little movement and leeway when you install the final piece that will go up to the fuel strainer. Now, all y'all out there in the audience, don't be laughing at my F-script moccasins that you see there in the lower left-hand of the screen. That's how I keep comfortable in the garage. Okay, going to give this just a little bit of a bend before I install it, and then we'll bring our fitting back from that fuel line there, as I showed you there at the bottom of the middle of the screen. And I'm going to install again a little bit of sealant onto the threads here before I install it onto the flexible line. Once again, you don't need a lot of sealant. Just kind of roll it around there on the fitting with your finger there and just make sure that you cover the threads. You don't want a whole bunch on there. We don't want to gob it up. I have to stress that every time I show you these fittings. I know it's kind of funny, but somebody will put too much on there and then I'll have to hear about that. Anyways, we're going to go ahead now and screw the fitting into the backside here of the flexible line into the female fitting, and then we'll need to use two wrenches to tighten that fitting together. Now this fitting I'm not going to leave loose like we did on the one on the fuel pump, and I can still move that around a little bit, and I may need to when I install the final line here that goes to the fuel strainer. So just using the two wrenches here, we'll just go ahead and we're going to tighten this down until we feel it bottom out, and then we're going to give it one last little snug to make sure that that joint is sealed. I'm going to go ahead here and grab a hold of this flexible line, just kind of bend it upwards towards me as, again, we're going to the fuel strainer from here, and that just give it a little pre-bend to help us out here with our next fitting. All right, the last line that we need to attach is the one I'm showing you here. It looks like this, and that one is going to go from that flexible line we had on there to the fuel strainer cap that we installed in the previous video. I'll show you here exactly how this goes in. The larger of the bends is going to go down to the splash shield there, and then that smaller bend that's at a kind of a 45 degree to the whole thing will fit into that elbow on the fuel strainer cap. I'm going to spare you the agony of watching me put my sealer on my fitting, so I've already done it here, and then we're just going to go ahead here and we're going to attach that fitting to the elbow that's on the fuel strainer cap. I'm just going to do this one by hand again, and then this one I will tighten up when it's all said and done. I don't know if you notice or not that my fenders are missing, but that little piece of cloth loom will fasten to a fender eventually after I get the fender on there, so it just makes it really easy for us to see how clear this is. And then we're going to go down to the bottom there on that fitting, and we're going to connect it to that side, that female connector side of that flexible line that we installed just a few minutes ago. Once again, I've installed the sealant already onto the male connector side there, and I'm just going to screw this into the female connector side on that flexible line that we just installed a few minutes ago, and then I'm going to work it back and forth so the sealant gets a good chance to get into those threads, and then I am going to tighten these up fully with the two wrenches. That flexible line will give me a little bit of movement when I have to install it onto the fender, and I promise you I will show you how that's done in the future. Okay, here we are again. Let's take a look through the whole system now. There's your fuel line that comes from the out part of the strainer, goes down, comes to the flexible line above the splash shield for the generator, comes up behind the generator, and then travels over the front of the engine on the timing cover, and then comes out the opposite side there where it connects to our fuel pump. And I'll give you a good look here how it comes down the front side of the timing cover and then connects there to the fuel pump. Then from the fuel pump, we installed that line. When we installed the fuel pump and the carburetor, that line goes to the carburetor, to the elbow fitting on the carburetor.
Yes, yes, yes. That last fuel line there that went from the fuel pump to the carburetor, that is a Joe's Motor Pool WO reproduction carburetor. Five thumbs up for those carburetors. They were fantastic. All right, so that's part two of the fuel filter strainer restoration. The fuel lines kind of go with that. In the next video, I'm going to show you the element that goes inside, both the World War II one and the paper ones that are available today from Ron Fitzpatrick Jeep Parts, and we'll go through that in the next video. Thank you for all the subscriptions we get lately. Seems to be growing leaps and bounds. Must be a lot of y'all out there working on your Jeeps, and that is fantastic. Okay, if you'd like to subscribe, you can click the subscribe button down there, and you can also click that little bell that you see, and that will give you notifications of when we release the next videos, because I'm going to try to pump them out now every couple days and get caught back up to the point where I'm at with that Jeep. I'm getting excited. I'm excited about what's going on this channel, so let's just keep it rolling. Until next time, my friends, keep it safe and happy Jeeping.